got to win the game to the people who run it, to the people who own it, that unless you're free, the machine will be prevented from working at all,
Don't lay down and die because a new world order, the business of the day for the elite, when they're coming to take your freedoms away.
Hello again, human beings from the planet Earth. I got a bit of a drive ahead of me, so I thought I'd come to you for a few topics. First of all, Alex Jones, you didn't infiltrate shit. Alex Jones infiltrates Bilderberg by boat. No, you didn't. You jumped on a fucking boat. You were still just as far away from any real information as everybody else was. And I think it's sickening that you waste so much fucking time sending your bloggers and your reporters, and then now you yourself going sucking money out of people to take a fucking boat ride a half a mile away from any information. It just seems like... I remember last year, out of 70 videos put out over the course of the Bilderberg meetings, 51 of them were fucking Aaron Dyke standing in the rain, again, a half a mile or more away from any real information. And folks, the supporters of Alex Jones are paying for that, okay? It's just ridiculous, and I don't begrudge anybody for doing well and making money. It's the system we live in, but come on, cut the bullshit. Infiltrated the Bilderberg, my balls. You didn't do shit but waste video time. All right, but I'm not here to talk about Alex Jones, because he's a flea on my ass as far as I'm concerned. This thing about, you know, the PRISM and NSA spying on you all the time, I want you to really think about it, folks, because you knew it all along. We've known it for how long? I mean, I knew it back when I was a kid, that they used to listen in on certain people's phone lines. You could hear that clicking, and you knew somebody was listening, right? So nothing has changed. And do you really think that when you're on Facebook and Twitter and YouTube, that governments and entities are not going to use that information? Now think about why they'd be flooding you with that fact right now. Maybe it's because there's too much information being shared. And usually when you get scared, you turn away from that thing. That's my theory. That they're just giving you this information and flooding it in the media to scare the fuck out of you so you'll stop sharing information. But I want you to think about that, because you knew it all along. Okay? And yeah, there is a risk. Yes, somebody could show up and whisk you away and nobody ever hear from you again. But, and I'm going to call the Christians out on this one. If you're that fucking scared of death, what hope do you have? You've got to draw the line in the sand and eliminate the fear. No, I don't want to suffer physical pain. No, I don't want my family to worry. No, I don't want my kids to be abandoned. But if you have any real faith in what life is really worth and what life really is, then you'll know that it extends beyond your time here in this physical sense. Now, I can't put a definition on that, tell you how to get there, but I know that it is, or I believe it is anyway. So, don't let it scare you. Let them hear us. That's the problem. You stayed silent for too goddamn long that the few of us that had enough balls to say anything were able to be labeled terrorists by the government that scared the fuck out of you. Now, who's terrorizing who? Who's the real terrorist here? Don't be scared. Don't be scared at all. I want to talk about the division. I'm going to pull off, because as soon as I'm done here, I got to use the restroom. But anyway, I want to talk about the division, okay, in the political thing. Now, division, they always know, right? Divide and conquer, divide and conquer. and they're still doing it. And they're able to do it within the truth movement and the activists, because again, there's so many things to fight. When you're good at something or you understand something and you're an activist against that, say whether it be the chemtrails or the nuclear industry or the political system, whatever it is, you may begin to argue with other truthers who are in a different line of activism, because you think your activism is more important than theirs, that maybe the nuclear is killing everybody and we don't really need to worry about the geoengineering because it's less harmful. I don't know, whatever, but I'm saying it's causing a division. I see it. Knock it the fuck off. Okay? Knock it off. They're all equally important, and unless we rectify them all, we're screwed. We can't just fix one of the things. It's gone too far. We need a mass uprising. We need a large awakening, and I think it's happening. I know for myself that there's things that I think about that I reason out in a way that I never have before. So again, I think we're still in a growing learning stage here on Earth. I think, you know, I see Earth like the womb. And once I leave here, I've got the rest of the world, my life. You know, this is a short time, and you're here to grow. To be able to handle what else is out there and take part in that, whatever that might be. And I'm sure it'll be a little different for everybody, as it is here, because we're all a little different. But don't let the division separate you. We all, you know, I cover a lot of topics. I'm trying to fight everything all at once, and some people say that's foolish, you're not effective, but then again, I want everybody to see that all these things are going wrong, and I might not be able to be an expert in any one of them, but I can surely connect to the ones that are and let you know where to find them and tell you to listen to them. So knock off the division. Now, the last thing I want to talk to you about is this, the politics, okay? Because what I see is you got pissed off at the system, and you started squabbling and hating government, and so they threw out the Tea Party to rein some of you back into the system. And that was all right for a while. But now most of you are even seeing through Ron Paul. Oh, but wait. Here comes Adam Kokesh and the libertarians. Now, if you go to the wiki and read up on what libertarian is, you'll see that it grasps a hold of all the things that quote-unquote truthers want. Okay? But what you're not seeing is that it reins you back in to the same system of believing that your vote is going to change a goddamn thing. And it's not. The system doesn't work. It failed twice already in history. It's failed now. They haven't told you. And the other half of that equation is you taking responsibility for yourself and for your neighbors. It's not just the government's fault, folks. We allowed it to happen. We allowed it to happen because we have no time to cook a meal for our neighbor who's hungry. We don't want anybody sleeping in our spare bedroom or in the outbuilding on our land. We don't want to do any of those things. So, as much as, you know, this system needs to change, I'm an advocate for all the governors running the country. And I think that will return power to the people. But that's a long way down the road. And, you know, who the hell am I? I don't have all the answers. They're just suggestions, ideas, thoughts. Think about them. Anyway, I got to use the restroom and get on with my drive. Much love, many thanks, and good Lord willing, I'll see you soon.